Hello and welcome to a new episode of Asakasan. Today we shall be looking at the flip side of being in a relationship. That is, how do you deal with a broken relationship? To help us understand this topic better, we have with us a guest from our last episode, Ms. Vianne Almeida. Thank you, Vianne, for joining us again today.
Thank you, brother, for having me back.
So, Vianne, right from the beginning, I'd like to say, we've received a lot of feedback about the last episode that we had, and a lot of positive feedback. People said that it really helped them in understanding how it is that a relationship should be like, right? Mm-hmm. And I'm very sure that, having said that, a lot of people do fall in love. And there are also many young people who struggle with how to deal with a broken relationship, right?
So, yeah.
In your experience, right to begin off with, what are the different reasons you think that, young people break up in a way, or why do relationships of people end? Because we all begin with loving each other.
Yes.
where do things go wrong?
Okay, yes. So breaking up is much related to, first of all, why do we enter into the relationship? Okay, what is our intention of getting into that particular relationship? If we know that we have entered into this relationship for our own selfish reasons, then yes, this relationship sooner or later will come to an end, definitely. It will not last long. But there are other factors also that contribute to a breakup that we see nowadays, such as misunderstanding or trust issues, loyalty issues, lack of communication between the partners, insecurity, jealousy, controlling the other partner, or even external factors such as distance or family consent, lack of family's consent, or religion or caste differences. So all these do interfere with the couple's life, and if the relationship is not strong, it will lead to an end to the relationship or a breakup.
Okay.
What are your views about it?
I'm just adding to this, there's also this point of commitment, that I feel that comes up a lot, today, at least with this generation that we have. If you look at our earlier generations, our parents and our grandparents, and the kind of, though relationships are not perfect for them also.
Correct.
They tended to, stick on together. Whereas nowadays we say that it's much easier to let the relationship go.
Correct.
Why do you feel that happens? Today the generation or the youth of today are not that willing to work at a relationship. Hmm.
They don't want to put much efforts. They think it is better to just leave everything.
Why do you think that has happened? Why is it easy to just say bye-bye and go?
As you said, it's commitment. There's a lack of commitment between people, and they feel that there is a lot of options available. They want to explore also, and they don't want to be committed to only one person. So they want to keep their options open.
That is
why you see this trend lately.
Okay, you mentioned in your previous answer that relationships break for different reasons.
Mm-hmm.
In my experience, and I have come across youth who are in a relationship, but for another person, another person can look at that and say that there is something wrong here. But
correct.
That person is I don't know what you're talking about. My relationship is perfect.
Mm-hmm.
How does one person know, my relationship that I am is an unhealthy relationship, what you say, a toxic relationship?
Okay.
What are some of the features, which a person who is in can know, mm-hmm. or even somebody else can guide the person and tell her, there's something wrong.
Something is wrong.
Yeah.
Yes. As you said, when a person is in the relationship, they are fully in the grind, they are fully involved. They cannot see the bigger picture.
Right.
So, yes, they do require somebody from outside or a third person to intervene and show them what is the reality. People tend to overlook the faults, the red flag. They tend to overlook it just for the sake of continuing the relationship or being in that comfort space of theirs. Okay, some of them are scared to move out or different reasons. If they are insecure about their own self, yes, they require the support of their other partner. So, they tend to overlook the bad things. Some of the signs which one can look out for in a relationship could be physical, verbal, or emotional abuse, too much of controlling of one of the partner, or there is this term known as gaslighting, wherein the manipulator will make you feel that something is wrong with you when you try to confront them, and then you start questioning your own sanity. Okay, so this is one of the ways in which they try
that
to manipulate and dominate.
Gaslighting.
Yes, it's called gaslighting.
Okay. Gaslighting.
Okay, and then there is also something known as love bombing, wherein it is at the start of a relationship wherein one partner tends to shower a lot of love, affection, gifts and kind to the other person,
okay,
just with the intention of dominating or controlling them at the later stage of the relationship. Okay, so all this signs cannot be ignored. They should be looked up, looked at, and something should be done about it. If you tend to ignore them or stay quiet about it or keep it to yourself, thinking that what will the other person think or what will others outside the relationship think about you, it shouldn't be that way. You should take a step, because if you don't, you are in fact encouraging the other person and they feel more confident to continue doing what they are doing, which is not correct. So in order to stop this toxic behavior or this toxic dealing with each other, you need to take some step, you need to take some stand. Either do it yourself or ask for help from somebody. There's no shame in asking for help. It is only that you are more self-aware and you want to have a healthy relationship with people around you. That's all.
I think you said a very important thing there about emotional abuse also, right?
Mm-hmm.
I think many a times the person in the relationship does not really know that, you know, there is something wrong in this, because generally we look at like, you know, physical abuse, okay, he should or he or she should not hit me or something like that.
Yes.
But this whole aspect of emotional abuse, you know, I like to relate it with what the points we brought about in the last episode about a good relationship should have freedom, trust and respect.
Correct.
If these three things are missing and you as, you know, a person in the relationship feels somewhere that you are not being respected, that somewhere your freedom is being curtailed, you know, somewhere you are not being trusted or constantly being put down.
Put down.
Even these are, you know, the things of abuse, which are not healthy in a relationship. And I think quite often we tend to like overlook this part only of it. And it's just like, you know, he should not raise his hands. But even if that other person is doing these things, like, you know, constantly putting you down, shouting at you in public or using abusive language with you, I think all these also are not acceptable behavior, and which are contribute being in a toxic relationship.
Yes.
Now let's get down to the main question. Okay. Because of all these factors, things go wrong and we know that relationships end. How does one deal with it in a healthy way or rather in a good way?
Okay. So once the couple breaks up, how to deal with it depends much on the reason for which they have broken up, okay? Both the parties should have an equal understanding of the reason for breaking up. Most often people, they don't want to confront and they try to ghost the other person. And they don't want to confront them, they don't want to give them a valid reason. That's not the correct way to break up. So whenever you wish to break up, it is important to provide a valid reason to the other person so that they can come to terms with this whole process of breakup. Okay.
Right.
And when you are at the receiving end of the breakup, you may go through a lot of emotions such as anger, revenge, even betrayal, or you feel lonely. Suddenly the person is gone. You have nothing to do without them. If you are full life was dependent on this one person, you may also feel a loss of purpose in life. So all these emotions need to be dealt with. You cannot push them away by engaging in some other behavior like consuming alcohol or getting into some other addiction or self-harming behavior, or even venting out on social media, okay? All these behaviors will not solve the problem, but in fact, it will only add to the already existing problem. So it is very important to deal with these emotions. And how to do that? You can always speak to somebody, speak to your friends, speak to your family, speak to any trusted adult. Your friends can be a good support system for you at this time to help you deal with the breakup. You can hang out with your friends, spend time with them, avoid staying alone because this will make you more depressed. So surround yourself with people who love you, who care for you. You can also fill this void by engaging in some productive activities, like you can revisit some old hobby that you've left off or explore something new. Try to meet new people, spend time with them, get to know them. And this is and in this way, you'll be able to cope with the grief of this relationship. If you have nobody to talk to, again, as I said, you can always reach out to a professional for help. What do you think, brother? How do you deal with a breakup? What would you suggest?
Well, for me, I think, first of all, everyone needs to understand that breaking up or a relationship ending is normal. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
All of us at some stage have gone through it. Okay. You are not the only person who has gone through it.
Yes.
Like the first thing I will try to make that person understand that it's natural, it's normal, it happens. This doesn't mean that your life has ended, okay? Because generally, you know, whenever I come across youth, they're like, okay, my life is done. Now there is nothing, there's no purpose in my life anymore. he or she was the only one I was living for, and then I have to like, okay, now come down to reality.
Correct.
Okay, fine, it happened. We understand. It's painful. We understand. But this doesn't mean that your life is over. Okay, this is one of the first things that the person has to understand. It's a part of life. It's normal. It's natural. It happens. The second stage then comes, and as you mentioned, you know, how do you deal with the emotions of it? Whatever they may be, there might be feelings of betrayal, there might be feelings of pain, might be feelings of anger. It's important to deal with these emotions properly in a healthy way with professional help, doing different methods. Okay, if none of those are available, don't suppress them. At least take it out in a healthy way. Write a letter and tear it off and throw it away. Something like that you do. So that you are able to express those emotions and take it out, or take it out on a friend, or talk to that person. Once those things are done, I think you will be in a better state of mind to think rationally and to see what is your next step. So I would really say, to sum it up, don't suppress it, or don't tell that, you know, I'm perfectly okay. Fine, you are hurting, you're in
pain. So also, if you try to suppress your feelings, you are only delaying the process of healing. You will put it. You will try to push it further away when things get worse, and then it will be difficult to handle everything all at once. So yes, dealing with it at the right time is important.
Is important. And also, as you mentioned, do some productive activities, some hobbies, or some thing which you didn't have the time for earlier. Try to take it up and fill in that void again. So if there is a void in the first place, there is a problem. So that void should not be there. That person should not be filling the void. And the person goes away, that void is created.
Correct.
So you need to see, what is it that I'm missing? Am I missing friendship? Am I missing people in my life? Am I missing, you know, a sense of self-esteem is low? So all these things are kind of connected, which need to be pointed out. Okay, so then we come on to another question which people generally tend to ask, like, you know, I have been in a relationship now. When do I get into another relationship? How long should I wait? Or should I wait? Or I will never get into another relationship again. I'm done for with life. How would you answer somebody like this?
Okay, yes. So once you go through the whole process of breakup, and as we discussed, there should be enough of time for you to heal first from the first relationship, from the pain and wound of that old relationship.
Right.
Only once you have dealt with it all, only then you can take a next step into finding somebody else to enter into a new relationship with them. If you do not attend to these feelings and try to suppress them, you will carry along with you these unresolved issues into the new relationship. If you jump from one relationship to the other, you are not dealing with those problems. You're not giving enough of time to heal. So then what will happen is you are carrying the same problems from this one relationship, which is suppressed in you. And then you go to a new relationship, and at some point, this will come back up on surface in the new relationship as well. And then you will see a similar pattern in both the relationships. Okay. So that is where you need to deal with this relationship, deal with these feelings. Also, you should understand that you cannot carry the expectation of an old relationship into a new relationship when you enter. You need to understand that no two people are same. So you need to deal with everything, whether it is your pain, whether it's your expectation of the other person, whether it is your need, whatever it is, it should be dealt with. And you need to enter the new relationship with a fresh view about it. You cannot have the old same expectation that you can just carry from one relationship and just put it upon the other person, the new person. They will get too overwhelmed with it, and they will not be able to handle it. And then you will mess up the new relationship as well. Yes. So you need to first give time. And if in the healing process, you do find somebody who could be your potential partner, take time to know them better. You don't have to rush into a relationship as soon as you find somebody. You can still carry on your healing process and be friends with this other person. You don't have to rush into a relationship with them. If they feel the same for you, they will wait for you.
Right. Okay, Rian, so let's at the end of it, what is one piece of advice that you would give to all our young and old viewers? How do you deal with something that is so basic? Getting into a relationship, dealing with something dealing that with is broken it. Up. What is like a final piece of advice that you would give?
Okay, so I would like to tell everybody that these things do happen. Everybody goes through it. It's a phase. It will not last for long. This pain will not last for long. But whatever you do, you should learn from your previous mistakes and don't commit the same mistake again and again. It just means that you're not learning anything in life. Okay. So whatever you have committed, try to learn something from it and put it to con and put conscious efforts to implement it in your next relationship. Also, don't sit around waiting for somebody to come to you or to get into a relationship. Don't go looking out for somebody. Just do what you're supposed to be doing. Like if you are a college student, you can continue studying. You can focus on your career, plan your future. Do what you're supposed to be doing, and the right people will, and you will attract the right people in your life. Yes. And also when they're making big decisions in your life, always try to seek help from an elder or somebody who knows better about that particular aspect, be it your relationship, be it your career, be it your marriage, or be it anything. Any big decisions, always take advice from somebody and then enter into it. Because without knowing about it, you just can't enter into it and then make a mess out of it and then say what to do. Okay, so that is my only advice I would like to give.
Okay. Thank you, Vian. It's been a great pleasure listening from you, hearing. I've learned so many new things, gaslighting and love bombing. Okay, I never heard of those things before. It's been a great pleasure having you. And we really wish that all our viewers will benefit from these two episodes. Okay. And so in case, again, like if you have any issues, any difficulties with any relationship, or if you know somebody who's having any difficulties, you can always reach out to us. Our email addresses are there in the description below. All right. Again, thank you, Vian, and all
thank
of you.
Thank you, brother.
See you again soon. Take care. Bye-bye.
Yes, bye.